Hello and welcome. My name is Cassandra, aka the Prosperous Heart, owner of www.prosperousheart.com, and I'm here today to share with you something really exciting. But first, I have a question. Do you own a business? And if so, are you currently utilizing Facebook Messenger inside of your marketing? If not, I have something super cool to share with you today. In this video, I'm sharing with you just one Facebook Messenger bot tutorial to help you start gaining more leads so that you can create more results in your business. So first of all, the difference between email marketing and Facebook Messenger marketing is that with email marketing, I hate using this term, but saturated, right? People don't really check their email as much anymore. They sign up for a whole bunch of stuff and then get inundated with a bunch of emails. And on a good day, you might have a 13% open rate and a 2 to 3% click-through rate. But with Messenger marketing, you have a much higher on average open rate. I've seen 60% or better on average for myself, and I'm only getting better and better every day. And I've seen some people average 80 or 90% open rates, and the click-through rates even higher, usually at least 10%, because again, it's based off of your ability to create a better Facebook experience. So what am I going to share with you today? I'm going to share with you how you can utilize something called a keyword in your Facebook Messenger chat, Facebook Messenger bot usage for your business. So what is a keyword? Just like anything else in Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, those things are called hashtags, aka keywords. Now, when you use these keywords, it allows you to find more posts that have that keyword or hashtag in them. With keywords on Facebook Messenger bots, it's a little bit different, because what happens is when you send a keyword into a Facebook Messenger bot, what you get back is what's called a Messenger bot flow. There might be other terms for it, but that's basically what it is. So I'm going to go ahead and show you an example, first of all, by going to my page and sharing with you one of the things that I've done. So first of all, I'm going to unlike this page. Actually, that probably didn't make any difference on the chatbot side of things. So I'm just going to click on message. And as you can see, it's already told me some people have interacted with some of my Messenger bot information. So I'm just going to send here, let's say, I think it's AMVS2017. So when I send that keyword into my Facebook Messenger bot on my page, I automatically get this message back saying, first of all, it alerts me that somebody, aka myself, sent in the keyword. And then it says, welcome, first name, which if you have not already sent in a message to their bot, there is a layer of protection that Facebook has that Jesse talked about tonight on the Attraction Marketing Summit, which if you do not have your free ticket yet, be sure to get his information ASAP, because it was an awesome, awesome training. But anyway, so this will not show the person's name unless they've already interacted with your bot, because it's Facebook's way of trying to make sure that you're not being spammy for people. It's just one way. So I go ahead and say, you know, is it okay to send you the link here? So that way they can interact with that initial post. That way there's that handshake and I can send them the link for it. If you just send it right away, you don't necessarily get them. While they do get on your bot and you can send them broadcast messages, there are certain rules that you need to follow, or else you can get your page shut down with ManyChat if you don't do it right. So I have said, thank you for subscribing. Is it okay if I send you the link here? Tap the yes or no button below, and then I'd let them know if they want to stop at any time, just send me a message of stop. And so I'm going to say, yes, I want the information for that summit, because that's what I sent the keyword for. So as you can see, my bot responds back, okay, great. Click on the AMVS button below on how you can win, et cetera, et cetera. So you can begin to see what this is going to do. It creates a campaign for you. You're able to save some really cool information about people based off of their interactions with your chatbot, such as their email address, such as the fact that they were interested in the Attraction Marketing Summit or whatever it is that you're promoting. You can learn things like getting their opinion on things. There's so many opportunities with Facebook Messenger bots. It's insane. I personally use ManyChat, and I'm going to show you how you can create a keyword funnel like this one has seen here. So like I said, you can just click here and it takes them to the link that I would be promoting, which if you, again, if you are not on this summit yet, get on it because it's amazing. All right, so first things first is you have to have a ManyChat profile, and you just, it's really easy to sign up. I'm not doing that in this video, but what you do is you come here to automation and then you click on keywords. As you can see, I have a bunch of different keywords that all do different things. So first of all, let's go ahead and do a keyword. So we're going to come up here to the top right and click on new rule. Each keyword needs to be separated by a comma. So for this one, I'm going to do, let's just say blog for now. So I pressed enter, and when someone sends me blog, I'm going to create a reply. Blog keyword request. I'm going to name the very first note so that I know where this is going to come from if I ever have to duplicate this process again. And you know, the same thing, right? So hey, so if I want to add it a name, I can click this little person here and choose first name, last name, full name, etc. But I'm just gonna do first name. If you have not made that connection yet where they have interacted with your bot, then you can say friend here or hey you or whatever the case may be. It's a fallback. Press enter, and then there's your first statement. Hey Cassandra, thanks for requesting information about my blog. Would you like it sent here or to your email? And so there's a couple of options you can do. You can do add button here, but this is just a single button to be pressed. You can't create multiple, I mean, you can create multiple buttons, but they have to be, they'll be looking like this instead of the ones across like you saw in the keyword one that I had. Now, you can leave these here, but the big difference between having these buttons and the quick replies is that the buttons allow them to be able to tap on all the buttons. So it can kind of mess up your marketing. So these buttons really should be for things that might be standalone information, like on your welcome message where you are telling people, hey, what do you like to, what would you like to know more about? Facebook ad services, coaching, training, you know, just different pieces so that they can go back and click on them versus the quick replies, where in this instance I do want to have a quick reply because I just want the interaction. So first one would be for the yes. So I come in here and you can use it just as words here. If you add an icon image, this does not show up when they tap it. It's just more of an eye catcher. So you can use the hands here. And if you wanted to add them again in the message, you would come here to the little face and add it there. Now, once they tap that, only one of them will show up. That's the one on the right. The big one is again more for them to catch their eye. Now, if actually, I'm going to change this to the wording here, please. And then for this one, we're going to do email. Email, please. Now, from here, you have to continue the flow. So for the here, please, you know, you there's a couple of things. You'd want to add an action. I usually add a tag. That way, I can know where they came from. I usually, just for making sure that I have everything right, I usually make sure it's subscribed to bot. And I have a notify admins with Messenger only and what they did and how it came about, because then you're alerted to people actually making change, not making changes, but responding to your Messenger ads, excuse me, your Facebook Messenger ads, things like that. You can have, there's so many options here. I'm not going to go into all of them. I'm already at my 2-minute mark and I'm going to keep this short. But as you can see, you can start responding to this and making it look like a conversation, adding to the Facebook user experience. So once you've got this all figured out, what something really cool about this, and I can't click preview right now. Actually, let me go ahead and go to a different one. I'm going to turn that one off. and we'll go to AMVS. Sure why there's two here. So what I did with this one was I had welcome, thank you for subscribing. I had the yes and no buttons. If they clicked yes, it had this. If they don't send here, I had the email option so you can receive emails from people and put them in your email autoresponder if you have it. But what's cool about this is when you click on preview, it sends you the message. So as you can see, maybe it sent me the message of that welcome one to my phone so I can interact and I can tap on those buttons, right? I can tap on those buttons right there. Oops. Oh well. But as you can see, I tapped no and it goes on to go through the process. So thank you so much for watching. This was a Facebook Messenger bot tutorial or a Facebook chat bot tutorial on how to use the keyword option inside of ManyChat. So like I said, there is something going on right now. First of all, two things. One, if you're watching this on Facebook, be sure if you got value from this, like this post, share it if you think someone should hear it today, and be sure to subscribe so that you are aware as to when I next post the next update. If you're on YouTube, go ahead and click that subscribe button and then the little bell to be notified. And finally, like I was saying, there's something going on right now that's going to teach you how to be a better entrepreneur in 2018. It was really what it boils down to. There's a summit going on for 10 days. It's already day 6 or 7. I think it's 6. And every day, 4 speakers are coming out and talking about the different aspects of online marketing and network marketing, if you have that type of business, and Facebook ads, and you know, finding your target market. Everything that you need to know to have your business blow in 2018. And I mean blow in a good way, not like blow as in a, oh my gosh, a horrible way. Because when you know how to leverage the power of the internet, you can build literally any business online. So thanks so much for watching. If you want that information, go ahead and send me that keyword AMVS 2017 to my chatbot, or say summit down below if you're on Facebook, or just find me. You know, seriously, I am everywhere as ProsperousHeart.com. Feel free to reach out at any time, and have a wonderful and prosperous rest of your day.